Welcome back to another optics overview. Going to tell you the features, basic layout, and show you some of the build quality, this time of the Brownell's MPO match precision optic 1-8x24, a scope I wish I had just a couple weeks prior. More on that coming up next on GBGuns. So filming this in early May of 2021, I just got back from a really cool SR25 AR10 308 only mid to long range course that dictated max power of 6 or 8 power on an optic. Really interesting course, very educational, learned from some very talented people. All of my stuff was MOA, because as I've explained, we tend to shoot 100 yards on 1-inch grid targets for grouping, and so having an MOA-based scope just makes sense, makes it easier. MRAD, however, is the new hotness and the cool, thanks to military and, well, its simplicity of math. That is a whole nother subject that requires its own research and video if you want to learn about that. But long story short, I did not yet have this scope in. This scope is set up in MRAD with a pretty clever reticle. We'll show you that when we go outside. Also the illumination, picture quality, things like that. For now, let's take a look at build quality. Coming into, of course, starting with the focus piece here. You've got a nice dot there so you can see where you were. And this has got some good stiffness to it with a rather fluid turn. So, nothing too bad there. Nice knurling here on the zoom, but it also includes a little nub. You can see that one power starts us off at about 4 o'clock, and flipping it around to 8 power is about 7 o'clock. So you've got about a 2/3 throw there, which I think is fine. This being second focal plane, the reticle is only going to serve you accurately at 8 power, and most of the time, at least in the shooting course that I recently did, a scope like this is either at 1 power to be used sort of like a red dot, or at max power to reach out. Because, well, 8 power doesn't give you a whole lot. It does set, however, about the maximum of what is normally considered comfortable eye relief for a 24mm objective lens. Remember, we divide this lens diameter by our zoom, and that end result, so in this case 24 divided by 8, gives us 3. That's about as small as the human eye can comfortably focus on for any given period of time. But once again, if you're running a low-powered variable optic, chances are you're not going to be living at that max zoom. Our turrets are nice and large and capped. Spin off very cleanly. The capped turrets helps prevent them from getting bumped. We do have a little hash there, kind of a far reach from where the actual numbers are to see. Focus camera. Let me zoom back a little bit. Camera's getting old and tired, folks. Made a lot of videos. But you can see it looks like it lines up pretty straight. Our clicks are clean, almost no lash. It's either turned or it's not. Nicely set in there. This is made in Japan, which is one of the better optics making places in the world, so not surprised there. You can see that the cap can be removed to reset your zero, and it gives you a directional guide, as well as that these are 1/10 MRAD adjustments. This runs on a 2032, CR2032 battery, which sticks off the end there, and big, stiff, long throw adjustments to your illumination. Goes 1 through 6. And our vertical cap, take a look at our turret here. A little bit softer on the clicks. But very firmly in place once it clicks there. So this is probably going to help you gain a very precise zero, or accurate zero too, if you want to. Overall size and profile of the scope is rather slim. Got it in a Brownell's mount at the moment. Haven't shot this thing yet, but next let's go outside and take a look at the reticle as best I can show you, sitting it in front of another camera, as well as what the illumination looks like, and give you a bigger feel for possible uses of this Brownell's MPO 1-8x24. Now looking through the reticle that Brownell's 1-8. For the record, it is an Oregon spring late afternoon. It's a little dark outside, kind of gloomy, looks like some rain's coming. And I've got the reticle set to brightness level 6. You can see it's a floating center top there. Turn it off real quick. Awesome for making a precise shot. Sorry about the eye relief, it is a little tricky, and as with all of these videos, we've got the disclaimer that you're watching on a screen, something filmed through a camera, looking through other lenses. So light transmission, clarity, things like that are going to be totally different, and probably a whole lot better with the naked eye, but wanted to show you what I could to the best of my ability. Now as we look through the scope, that fence post is 8 yards away. The tree line back there is another 135 yards. If I can do this without messing things up there, I'm going to zoom you in all the way. That kind of grayish haze you're seeing there is probably more to do with the relationship of the camera to the optic than the optic itself. You don't really see that so much with the naked eye, but it gives you an idea of how well that reticle pops. And you can see clearly, though those lines look kind of thick, they are hollow, which lets you see through them. It's a really smart reticle. One power here, you've got a quick, fine red dot. Should be easy to point and find, as well as, of course, your mill marks there, smartly numbered vertically and horizontally to make it easier to make judgments on size or distance or for drop or windage. So this reticle would have been perfect at that training event I went to in Colorado. Kind of wish I had it. Unfortunately, I got to open the box when I got home from the trip. Just one of those things. But I hope this has helped you get a feel for this new Brownell's MPO 1-8x24. Seems to be a really smartly designed optic, great glass. If I pull the scope out of shot and let the camera adjust there, you're looking over the top of a table out there, but you get an idea for the color and lighting that we have out here. It almost looks brighter through the scope. That's pretty cool. I hope this overview has been helpful for you, giving you a little bit better idea of what this optic is than you can get from just reading stuff online or looking through a catalog, hoping to have a feel for something before you spend money on it. I'd say this thing is really nicely built, has a lot of nice features, and is certainly one of those scopes that could serve you well for close in at lower power and still have plenty of functionality to get out there and reach. And I'm saying that now as someone who's had the experience of using low powered variable optics at distance with the 308. Thanks for watching.